Hi everyone, Amber here, and I am going to show you today how to customize your availability in Acuity to optimize your schedule and ultimately save you time and build efficiency into your business. This has been one of the biggest features that has helped us utilize Acuity to catalyze our growth. In my opinion, this is one of the most powerful features in Acuity, and it has helped us at Summit Dog Training really optimize our schedules well. And so I want to make sure we cover it thoroughly so that you don't miss out on this awesome feature. Don't forget to click subscribe so that you will be informed when we post new videos on Acuity, on other dog topics. We'd love to have you stick around. As the Summit team has grown and expanded, we've run into scheduling conundrums for making the best use of our space and also not double booking appointments accidentally. So we use Acuity Scheduling permissions to set things up so that only one instructor is offering appointments in our training room location at a time. And while that is happening, other instructors can be booked for appointments at different locations, like at a park or at a client's home or another location that we might offer private services. So I'm going to show you how to do this in Acuity so that you can play around with it and customize it to what you might need. So let's dive in. Under availability on the left side of your Acuity dashboard, you will see all of the calendars that you have in Acuity currently set up. To edit the availability of a particular calendar, you will click this drop-down arrow and it will open up with all of the group types that are currently set up in your calendar. It starts with a default of like one group type, but then you can build them out from there. First, let's take a look on how this looks like on my calendar that's set up. You can see that I have my availability broken up into several different categories, such as initial consults, in-person follow-up lessons here, and online lessons in another spot here, so that I can toggle and adjust the availability for each of these appointment groups the way that I'd like it to be. This allows me to do something, for example, like block off just my availability for new clients to schedule. So you'll see here my initial consults for home visits and for training room consults are both blocked off completely. And this is because my calendar is full with current clients. So I removed my availability for new clients to be able to schedule just by removing the availability for these two appointment types. And I can then easily add availability back in when I open my calendar back up again. So to set up a new group of availability, scroll down all the way to the bottom of your current groups, and you're going to click on Set Different Hours for Certain Appointment Types. And then you can select the appointment types that you'd like to be in this new availability group. And I'm just going to select something that I wouldn't normally have on my calendar at all, just to give us kind of an easy example. So I'm going to make a new appointment group with these three appointment types in it, and I'm going to hit Save Appointment Types here. Next, I can select the availability that I want to offer these types. If I have regular hours that I want to offer these services, so say the same type of hours every week, then I want this box to be checked and I can put in, I want to offer these appointment types from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. on Saturday, and perhaps 1 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Tuesday. And then I would hit Save Regular Hours, and this would populate the calendar below the specific days with those default hours. Now, if I wanted to go in and change the hours for this date, I can click on this date and either delete the hours, say I'm out of town that week, and it removes those hours for scheduling, or I could adjust them into a different set of parameters for just one date and override the regular hours if I chose. Do you want to do certain appointment types on certain days only. Tell us about that in the comments. Envision a little bit about what differences in your calendar might look like and how you might set that up to utilize this feature to best optimize your calendar. Tell us below so we can get your ideas and thoughts on that. Okay, back to working on our availability settings. So next set of scheduling limits that we can work on after we set our hours of availability is the client scheduling limits section. This is, again, just for the appointment types in this group and will override the default that you have set for your whole calendar. You want to add permissions here, such as how far in advance students can schedule or reschedule their appointment if there's a specific thing that you need with that particular appointment types. For example, perhaps I don't want clients to schedule this type of appointment more than 48 hours in advance. So with the settings here, I can change that to 48 hours and save limits here. And now if a client comes up to 48 hours before the time they wanted to schedule, it will no longer show them that time as available. They'll have to schedule out further than 48 hours. Then we click save and we are all set. It is important to remember that these permissions only affect these types of appointments on this calendar. So say, for example, one of my associates wanted something similar set up on their calendar, I would need to go and create a group with these type of appointments with these scheduling limits on their calendar as well in order to apply those limits. So for example, if instructor A teaches private lessons in the training room Mondays 3 to 8 p.m. and instructor B teaches private lessons in the training room Tuesdays 12 to 4 p.m., you would set up a group on each of their calendars with that appointment type, private lessons in the training room, and then just have the different time range available on each of their calendars. All right, you're all set. I always like to run a test run to make sure that the appointment types that we set limits for are actually showing up for the time that we would like them to. So I've gone and found the appointment type for this this appointment we set up a group appointment for, and I'm gonna click on this link here and see what it takes me to. So here's my calendar here. And it shows that I could schedule on Thursday or Saturdays between those windows, which is how we set it up. So I would say that is working correctly, and we can consider that part done and ready to move on. Does the time that you expected your appointment time to show up for actually show up? Once you've done your testing and it's showing up exactly like you'd like, then you're done and good to go and ready to get that calendar out there with those customized availability. To learn more about setting up Acuity for your pet business, I've created a free 10-part checklist on everything you need to know to get you started, to get your initial launch of Acuity for your business off the ground. You can grab that checklist below in the description, and I hope that it helps catalyze your efforts to get Acuity set up for your business. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, comment below with any questions, and we'll see you next time for our next video.